Jordan still out here for round four of the Bojangles Summer Shootout. It's wild and wet tonight, and Tristan's photobombing me for video bombing. All right, so tune in for the rest of the night.
Have fun in Charlotte.
Ain't nothing like a kiss out back in the barn. Ringing out our soaking clothes, riding out a thunderstorm. When the tin roof gets to talking, that's the best love we make. Corn makes whiskey, whiskey makes my baby feel a little frisky. Back roads are bogging up, my buddies pile up in my truck. We hunt our honeys down, we take them into town. Start washing all our worries down the drain. Rain is a good thing.
All right, so we caught up with Skylar Chaney, who wrapped up beginner Mandalero heat race. How was your heat race like?
Oh, it was okay. I got a good start, and I made a nice move at the start. I passed two people at once, but the car really started to push on me, and it's hard to do something with a pushing car.
We got the heat race out of the way, and now we're under a little bit of a weather delay. So Mother Nature needs to stop what she's doing and go away. Let the sun come back.
Yeah.
Rain is a good thing.
So we caught up with Lucas Vera here. Bandos are a little bit, and we're under a little bit of a weather delay right now. Legend cars are able to run, bandos are not. So what you doing, Lucas?
Right now I'm meeting Bojangles, you know, just waiting till the rain goes away and the Mother Nature could just move away. Hopefully I want to get back in the car so I could race tonight.
Mother Nature is kind of a Debbie Downer tonight, right?
Yeah, sometimes is.
Well, hopefully the rain will hold off tonight for the bandos to get to be able to get some laps in their feature tonight, and hopefully we can get Lucas up to a top five.
Corn makes whiskey, whiskey makes my baby feel a little frisky. Back roads are bogging up, my buddies pile up in my truck. We hunt our start washing all our worries down the drain.
Okay, I am subbing for Jordan today to do the interviews for all the drivers. I'm going to hear Trent first. So, we both did the Young Lions race tonight. How did you feel?
I felt, you know, it was kind of scary going into, like, the rain race, being so wet, you know, everybody, you know, spinning out and just, like, on ice. But, you know, I managed to hold it down with a solid P13 finish, and the car felt amazing. I felt so fast. I was up there, the times were with the leaders, and I just kind of fell off towards the end, but still managed to do it.
Dude, you held it together. I was right out there with you. Yeah, the track felt pretty fast there towards the end, yeah. Trent coming out with a solid P13, and we both finished tonight. We did good, bro. We did good. I'm here today with Cole Dockery. Ending the night a little bit early in the semi-pro race. He was really fast. He ran purple at the beginning of the race, and then tragedy.
I know. Yeah, man, I was in second when the motor blew, so after that, it's a disappointment, but we finished the best we could.
Dude, all I got to say is congrats. You were, like, the fastest out there tonight.
Appreciate it.
You were running faster than the leaders. Amazing.
It's heartbreaking, dude, but...
Maybe heartbreaking, but you're going to go out there and you're going to kill it next week. I know it.
Yeah, we're going to try to get it ready for next week.
Absolutely.
Thank you, man.
Hey.
All right, bud. Thank you, Stillwell, right?
My buddies pile up in my truck. We hunt our honeys down.
Now here with Tristan Lessick, it's basically the end of the night. Just finished up the semi-pro race. How did you feel out there in the mess of 26 cars trying to all get to first place?
I went from, like, up front to the back again, up front. And I think I either finished 7th. I think I finished 7th, but I guess the finish is under review. Car was really, really strong tonight. Really proud of my guys for giving me a great car, another great car. The whole shootout, they gave me a great car. So I just got to thank them. I got to thank all my sponsors, Blue Goon Cafe, Bonafide Energy Solutions, Collins Chiropractic, Still Racing, all the contingency sponsors, they've been a blessing to us. So thank you to them, and on to next week.
Dude, you know how to do an interview by yourself? yourself. You don't need me.
Yeah.
Absolutely, bro. That's Tristan Lessig. We did great. I was out of the camera frame for like most of the interview, but that's okay.
Right.
That's all right. Well, bro, see you next week.
Yeah.
Awesome. I'm gonna interview myself really quick. Okay, I'm Justice Calabro. I'm here with myself tonight because there's nobody else to interview me. I'm going to interview myself. So, Justice, how was your night? Well, you know, my night was pretty good. I ran pretty solid. I finished up in ninth place. You know, I did pretty good. I was running pretty fast towards the end of the race there. I was battling for the finish. Well, I can't do this. I need somebody to interview me.
So we finally caught up with my junior commentator, announcer, interviewer, journalist of the night, Justice. Thanks for helping us out as we were wrapping everything up over at Tech. But kind of talk us through your race tonight.
Well, I started pretty much dead last. I started in the last row. Working our way up through the wet of the track, it was extremely slick. I managed to get myself up to ninth and hold myself there for the rest of the race. There were three or four cautions, one red flag, and after the track cooled down and dried off a bit, I actually felt really, really fast. And I was able to hold it up in ninth place and just actually bring it home this time. I didn't even bend a bumper, and it rained. And I can't believe I finished my first race in the rain.
Not bad.
Yeah, not bad.
Bye, roll up your pants. Country girls, they want to cuddle. Kids out playing in a big mud puddle. Rain makes corn. Corn makes whiskey.
All right, so last one of the night, Garrett Lowe. Garrett comes home with a third place finish tonight. Awesome job tonight. You started all the way back deep in the field because of the rain. Didn't have a good qualifying run because of traffic, but you did awesome. How'd you get through all that mess?
I found the bottom about lap 15 or so, and nobody was running it, and it was really, really fast. Just rode all the way to the front, picked up as many spots as I could, and got to third, got a caution when everybody went in the oil, and we all went flying off the track, and we were able to stay in third for the rest of the race, but it was wild and crazy.
So, we talked about how difficult the summer shootout is overall, but how difficult was it to get to that third place finish tonight?
It was pretty difficult. Lane choice was a big thing because the top lane was really dry, and the middle had a big puddle in the middle of three, and everybody kept hitting it, and they would push wide and cause a wreck. But the bottom didn't really seem to dry off until about halfway, and I started running it more and more, and finally got it to where I could run it and pass cars. But the big thing was where people were making the aggressive moves that weren't working, and I was just making moves everywhere else where they weren't. So,
well, good job tonight, Garrett. Awesome job. Congratulations on your first career top five here at the Summer Shootout. And I guess that'll wrap us up for tonight. So remember, everybody here, it's still a race with PR. We're here with Garrett Lowe. And signing off for round four. Tune in next time for round five.